The Story of Life Punch, a short story by KoalaKandy. Preface. Dear readers, firstly, I'd like to thank you for taking the time to read The Story of Life Punch. This project is something I've created specifically for the benefit of the community to help highlight key points of Life Punch's past, understand how we feel about the server and community currently, and also look forward to the possibilities in the future for Life Punch. Please understand that none of the opinions in this short book are of my own except for my own page at the end, and are only formed as a result of 20 different interviews from members of the community of all ranks and many different account ages. It is probable that you will disagree with some or even all of the sections of this project, which is fair enough. This is not meant to be an account to please everybody. These are real opinions which people have divulged in private and confidential interviews so they can share their views without any fear of consequence. This book will hopefully identify areas in which you may agree with, and as a result of this, you can help to be part of a positive change in the community. We will also present the views of staff members such as Night Sky, super admin at the time of writing, and Monkeys, owner. This will help us to see how your views as the community may differ from those of staff. Also, we will display the views of former long-time developer Drew P. Richard from an exclusive interview. If you notice any errors, then please do PM me and I will try and edit them as soon as possible. After all, this is a community project and I am creating something based off your memories from times longer ago than the time I joined LP. Finally, enjoy. When did your journey with Life Punch begin? First off, in no particular order, we take a look at the ages of those members that shared their opinions and have made this book possible. Thanks, guys and gals. 2013, Anonymous. June 2012, Anonymous. October 2012, Anonymous. December 2015, Anonymous. October 2012, Anonymous. Late 2012, Anonymous. 12th December 2013, Anonymous. May 2014, Anonymous. Mid 2013, Anonymous. Mid 2015, Anonymous. Early 2014, Anonymous. Mid 2012, Anonymous. September 2014, Anonymous. Early 2016, Anonymous. Early March 2011, Drew P. Richard. January 2011, Monkeys. Late 2012, Night Sky. Late 2014, Degree. Time gone by. In this section, we look into the past of Life Punch and how it has developed into what it is today. Some memories are unforgettable, remaining ever vivid and heartwarming. Joseph B. Worthlin. Life Punch was founded in 2011 by Mr. Tickles, now known to many as Monkeys, the still current owner of the community. Many people question why Mr. Tickles changed his name to Monkeys. This was actually inspired from the time when his old username used to be Monkeys Ate My Homework, but that's too long for most websites, so it was shortened to Monkeys, and this lasts until today. The reason for starting the servers, according to Monkeys in an interview, was because other Death Run servers weren't as appealing to him, so he decided to make his own. Unbeknown to him that he would ever have something grow on such a scale as Life Punch, which has with 6 game modes on the platform of Gary's Mod. It is, however, believed that the Life Punch Gary's Mod servers never went live until April of 2011. Back during this time, Life Punch was a very small community, and Monkeys would never have believed the potential it had. He never predicted it would grow into the legacy server that it is seen as today. It was quite a slow start for Life Punch, with a very basic template web design. By November 2011, they had only just topped 100 members. With more threads than members, growth needed to come quick. As more Life Punch game modes were added throughout time, as Gary's Mod rose to become an internet favourite, The forums were also developed dramatically and started to include custom design. By the end of 2012, LifePunch had made a big impact in the Garry's Mod community, and in going into 2013, members of the community who had been interviewed have said that Jailbreak and Death Run were overwhelmingly popular. This was at the similar time to which Cinema and Gun Game were added. It can't be denied how popular LifePunch was. To see the March 2013 server numbers, all 8 Jailbreak servers nearly full, Death Run and Cinema both well populated, many members interviewed have reminisced about how full the servers were and how large the community was. LifePunch was writing its own narrative right there and then. There were no signs of growth slowing anytime soon. Unfortunately, this was LifePunch's heyday, and as such, all good things have to come to an end. Since its time in the limelight, the number of players on LifePunch servers have been slowly declining up until now. Garry's Mod itself was struggling as former players got bored after gaming thousands of hours away, and it's been increasingly difficult to attract new players with the competition of newly developed games. Only recently have LifePunch severely downsized, most noticeably with Jailbreak servers now being reduced to only 3 from its high point of 9. Next, we will be discussing what players' initial impressions of LifePunch were, no matter what their account age. It can be said that the overwhelming majority had only positive things to say about LifePunch when they first joined, else why would they stay? However, a select few had some negative comments about what they thought from the start. A common response in regards to this was that LifePunch is and was the best coded server, and it has a fresh and unique UI. This can especially be said as true once LifePunch started to grow and the community developed a fresh new face. See website update screenshots. Furthermore, and most importantly, many members commented that it was their peers within the community that made them stay. One user stated how the players and staff were friendly and were their main reason for staying, while another stated how the community was more appealing than the game itself. Even back in 2014 and 15, a member said everyone pretty much liked each other and knew everyone on a friend level, and they were always willing to talk to each other. The quote, "There is nothing on this earth more to be prized than a true friendship," by Thomas Aquinas, was certainly true for almost all that responded to this question. One member even stated about how they were having fun by joking around sucking dick for LP dollars upon joining LifePunch for their first time. Obviously, not all players remember this as a first memory of LifePunch. However, the one thing that most people remember about LifePunch a few years ago is about how full the servers were. One member discussed about what made LifePunch special was the fact that with it being a great server, with staff that worked their ass off for a lot of friendly players, you could hop between many full servers if you got bored of the game or players. "I thought it was a blast for the longest time," explained one interviewee. It's evident to see that LifePunch had made a lasting impression on nearly all those that had played on its servers and experienced its community, for a variety of different reasons which have influenced them to stay for such a long time and spend hundreds and thousands of hours gaming on its servers and browsing its forums. However, that impression was not all positive for some. One player stated about how they didn't like how strict the server was in comparison to others at first. However, since then, they have come to realise the importance that the rules have upon LifePunch and how they can affect gameplay for the better. Another member commented on how it was lame, especially on Jailbreak, whereby they were constantly getting killed as a new player and didn't realise why, along with another player who said LifePunch servers were just confusing. On the other hand, this issue has been resolved to some satisfaction, since with new player icons and a proactive approach towards helping them. As much as we try to avoid it on LifePunch, we are subject to drama just as much as any other server. After all, kids will be kids, and they do tend to make bad decisions along with overreact. I myself admit to this. However, in this section, I've asked members of the community who have been around for an extensive amount of time if drama was always present to the level it is today. Out of all the interviews taken, only one provided any evidence that there was more drama in the past than there is now. In fact, all the others provided evidence for the fact that there was a lot less drama in 2013 specifically. In contrary, one member stated about how the player base actually started to drop in 2014 as a result of drama, and there were still more people to start it back then. It was inevitable, and still is, that drama will occur. This can be debated, as some say that there could be a plethora of other factors for this, such as Gary's mod starting to die in popularity at this time, albeit not at a quick rate. What complements the last evidence is the subject, which is all about the overall community feeling for LifePunch in past times. There had been no interviewees which highlighted any negative feeling within the community in the past. They had all praised the 2012 and 2014 community, as it was no ordinary community. They were there for each other when they needed. No one was isolated. Furthermore, one contributor added that there were quite a lot of unofficial rebel groups on LifePunch, which helped to create a feeling of togetherness for those that were in them. However, it does leave the question if private circles were more prevalent back then in comparison to now, or maybe they have always been the same groups, just different players. The final topic to discuss regarding LifePunch's past is how community members felt about the former staff. It is again based on split opinion, as some believe that former staff were great because they communicated with each other to be fully aware of all the issues at the time, helping to create a community which everyone felt welcome. On the other hand, some other players believe that the previous staff's teams, especially those of 2014, were extremely fragmented, with backchatting and petty insults. In response to this, nearly all current staff members I have spoken to, both in and out of interviews, have said that most are no longer staff because of stupid things they have done. So if anything, it's a constant improvement process. In the next section, we will look to see how things in LifePunch are currently and how players feel about issues facing them right now.
Contemporary times. In this section, we research about how we feel about LifePunch in its current state. Do not dwell in the past. Do not dream in the future. Concentrate the mind on the present moment. In the last section of this book, we divulge into how people used to feel about LifePunch. The main reason for this is that we will now investigate what players' opinions are currently about LifePunch. This will in turn will allow us to compare if LifePunch has improved over time or transformed into something significantly worse. There is no easy way to generalize opinions for this subject, and therefore I'm going to highlight some key views which people felt they needed to make. Many people believe it's how things have changed around them that has made them lose faith in LifePunch. For example, one member stated about how they thought it was cooler for this, but since people started to get banned and left, they have found themselves drifting further away from the community. Another interviewee told me LifePunch is in no way as good as it was a year ago or even 2 years ago. They thought it's pretty bad now, they can't even get themselves to play on the service for more than 30 minutes. However, that might just because they played Gary's mod for 3 years straight. Despite this, they said they still lurk the forums because they're nosy, but they did comment the forums were funnier than they are now. Differently, some people genuinely believe that LifePunch has got better than its previous state, mainly due to the fact that they now understand the rules and community while making friends, which has made things easier. A few players remain indifferent, with someone saying that the gameplay has improved due to the fact that new additions have been made. However, a lot of people have left, and now it's very much single server. A minority of members I spoke to during the course of the interviews have said to me that their initial impression of LifePunch has not changed. One person in particular has said that they enjoy it equally now as they have met a lot of new people, but also been able to help more, having more trust, and speaking to more players frequently. Similarly, we will now look at if drama in LifePunch has changed over time and examine how players feel about it in correlation with their opinions of it in the past. Surprisingly, the opinions on this subject were split equally for if drama had increased or decreased, indicating it's very much a result of personal experience if you notice it or not. In terms of an increase in drama of late times, people have said that drama will always fluctuate as kids will be kids and create it for themselves. However, one person stated how drama is more noticeable due to hostility within LifePunch. On the other side of the spectrum, a few members mentioned that drama is only where you think it is, along with another saying that the only drama is people leaving and making big stupid posts seeking sympathy. Many believe that drama has started to die down since the start of the year and it's got a bit better recently. Notably, the most common response in regards to this is that they'd rather stay out of all drama for various reasons, including that it should be left alone and therefore they will leave their opinion blank upon the situation, along with the idea that it is not their place to intervene in it, especially staff drama. One player provided key advice, and it is that their general rule of thumb, never to get involved in drama if it's not your business, and certainly don't go around instigating it. Furthermore, most players would rather focus on the gameplay itself and even keep to themselves just to avoid such incidents from occurring for them. Whatever your opinions on drama, LifePunch is clearly split on the subject. Next up, we'll take a look at all of your opinions about LifePunch in general currently. It can be easily said that there are more people that have negative overall view of LifePunch. Per contra, we will first look at some positive opinions. For example, one participant mentioned about how they still like talking to others and having that social interaction each day which only LifePunch can provide for them. LifePunch has battled through a lot in its time and admittedly still is, but to some, it's a soldier which keeps surviving, one which people thought would already be dead now. However, it's here each and every day until its inevitable end. Although, some won't be as celebratory as one user and say, LifePunch is awesome the way it is, and fits my description of the perfect server. They will continue to agree that, despite its overtime, it remains satisfactory, yet special to them. Dissimilarly, a lot of negative comments cropped up about LifePunch, of which frequently was the lack of development of late times, without former longtime developer Drew P. Richard. However, there were some interesting individual comments made which are notable, and these include one member who said they don't like trollers and people that spread false rumors, especially if it affects reputation, which has become all too common with LifePunch's culture and hostility. Another criticism I wish to highlight of LifePunch is one member that said rules of popularity that have been made up in the community need to be sorted out and made a rule to appreciate all players equally, as it is starting to veer out of control. It is seen as quite a shame that LifePunch has many negative opinions shadowing over its legacy that has been made from its history. Everyone spoken to would love this to change, but as one member put it, I doubt the problems can be fixed. Anonymous. One of the hot topics discussed in nearly all of the interviews was about the general feeling of the community. Unfortunately, as similar to overall opinions of LifePunch, there were a lot more negative views highlighted as a result of this. Firstly, the general consensus for LifePunch having less of a feeling for community came from the idea that it is made up of separate social circles. As one member stated, it seems like everyone has a reason to avoid someone, and it feels as if people are just trying to get each other's band. This is along with the concept that there has been a decrease in quality of members within the community. Furthermore, some have stated that there will always be separate social circles, and it's something we have to deal with. While one player responded with, LifePunch could use more of a community environment, because right now, it's kind of hard to try and fit in and become part of the popular communities, as it tends to be awkward. Some people, however, remain indifferent to this issue, and one said that when a community is based around the players, and the players like to see they are the ones who are changing, it only goes downhill for old fags. This is while another interviewee exclaimed about how it makes them upset the way people don't realize they are the reason for the change, not the server. Despite all of this, some members had positive comments to make about the community and its current state, saying about how they still enjoy talking to people as much as, and if not more, than they do the game modes, whereas others explained they preferred private social circles, because people tend to get along better with those similar characteristics, and often that some players are uncomfortable as a person with going out of their way to meet and interact with new people. A final viewpoint on this side of the story is that it's generally fine as long as people don't have a mindset which thinks they control new players just because of their experience. The final topic while we explore how the community feels about LifePunch in present times is opinions on the staff. It can easily be said that from statements given, the current staff team has not received as much of the praise as the former ones did. In saying this though, there were still some positive comments about the current staff. For example, some felt they did a very good and professional job right now, upholding high quality and friendly admin standards. Another player said that they love them. However, they would sow more if they were just a bit more active. Specifically, one member displayed their view about how they have always been ready to help, regardless of individual opinion. As a side note, it is my duty to add all the truth and several comments were made about Canon / Canoon being an extremely professional staff member and in line for the next super admin role. Unfortunately, it is also my duty to cover the negative aspects of how the community feels about the staff members currently. A key response from one player has stood out. I find that it's too easy to become a staff member. You just need to fill an application full of lies and be a fake person, and I find that people try to secretly insult the LifePunch staff team, and it really just shows how immature this community can be. These are strong words, of which some people actually agree with. Adding that some of the staff wouldn't be so if they applied back in 2013/14. Currently, they're recruiting without so much consideration. Further issues which were discovered with the current staff team was that they were very lenient about their work, and they're oblivious about what actually happens in the community. It's not the best staff team we've ever had. The staff team just kind of seems apart. It doesn't seem like any of the staff members really talk to each other, said another contributor. A final issue, which one interviewee highlighted, was that they are taking pride in their title more than they are actually active in doing work for the community. These are certainly harsh words for the staff team, but will they take these comments on board? Time to say goodbye? In this section, address the issue of what the future holds for LifePunch, if any. Even though the future seems far away, it is actually beginning right now. Maddie Stefanik. It's time to look into the possibilities in the future for LifePunch. It can never be predicted. Anything could of course happen, but I asked a few questions to community members about what their personal hopes are for LifePunch and how they feel as a community we will move forward into the future, if at all. Firstly, I asked how long players would wish to stay on LP, and the overwhelming majority said that they would rather stay for a long time than planning on leaving soon. The main reasons given for this were that it's something to do with their spare time when they have free time. So, as long as they have that, they will be on LifePunch. Moreover, it's the fact that it is such a big part of their lives now. Some would feel empty that way in a way without it. On the other hand, a few people which stated that they wouldn't be around much longer gave the view that they have experienced everything they wanted and no longer have anything to achieve, while another member stated that they can't stay interested in the game modes anymore, and if the community is going downhill, it's unlikely they'll want to stay much longer. The next thing which I asked about was if some of the members had any rank ambitions in LifePunch at this stage. Looking towards the future, and of the few responses given, it was split. One said they have ambitions to attain EVIP and moderator would be a dream. However, due to their high outbursts of fun, they couldn't foresee that ever realistically occurring. On the other end of the scale, a member said that they didn't have rank ambitions as they don't care about helping it with the way it's turned out. Next, I asked members if there is anything they would change about LifePunch if they could, moving towards the future. The three main suggestions which cropped up were that, firstly, they wanted Drew to return, as they stated that development is far too slow at its current rate to help LifePunch stay popular in the Garizmod community. The second thing they would change is that somehow they would love to find a way to boost players back up to even half the original numbers. Third and finally, they would like a lot more involvement from Monkeys in the community as they feel like he has been drifting away from some time now, paying less attention on LifePunch. Although not all of these are easy fixes or even possible at all, the community would love to see at least some improvement based off the issues highlighted in this book. The last topic that needs to be covered as part of this section is if LifePunch will survive a long time. This can't be predicted, but the community have been asked to take their best guesses at possibilities. One of the most common opinions was encapsulated by this quote. LP will probably last a few more years because Garizmod is a dying medium, and some people who play have to go to work or they have troubles in life. And some young people probably who won't know about it, though I don't think LifePunch itself will die though. I really hope that Garizmod never dies. Others stated about how, as long as the community remains intact and no other foreseen circumstances occur, they would think it has 2 years left. However, most agree it's unlikely that Monkeys would ever give up on it. Another view presented was if all staff, team, and community work on getting new players and making them normal players, it will. It's all about funding the server with donations. If we don't get people to donate, it will die. To end this section, I would like to highlight the quote from one player. It will survive forever in our hearts. And as cliche as that is, LifePunch has made a lasting impression upon all of us that have been a part of the community over the years. So it won't be easily forgotten for most of us.
From the top.
Could well leave an empty hole inside of us.
In this section, we will demonstrate the viewpoints of influential staff transformed from an interview format to a direct point of view. Degree: former admin, resigned 24th of the 7th, 2016. I first joined the servers around late 2014. Following from this, I joined the forums and started becoming an active member of the LifePunch community in January of 2015. My initial impressions of LifePunch were that it was a laid-back community with quality custom game modes and an active player base, which is extremely important while searching for a Garry's Mod server and community. My initial impression has changed somewhat. LifePunch is definitely not the same as it used to be, but in terms of server-wise, it has significantly improved over the course of its time. I didn't always have the ambition to be a staff member. However, soon after becoming EVIP, the idea appeared in my head. Ever since I saw great EVIPs perform like Legacy, Lexus, and Alden, I always wanted to become one of them and assist the entire community. My view on drama is that it is always going to be everywhere you go, and there is no set way to avoid it. It is part of all our daily lives, and complaining about it doesn't help at all. The best thing you can do with it is to try to avoid it and not get yourself involved wherever possible. My same opinion sticks in terms of staff drama within LifePunch. LifePunch's community has always been a hit or miss when it came to making friends, in my opinion. A lot of people can be really judgmental, and if you don't make a good first impression, you're pretty much fucked socially. People have always had their own little friend groups where they like to exclude others. Why do you think so many people wanted private channels back on TeamSpeak? If they didn't have an issue with others joining, then they would just join one of the public channels. LifePunch has got to the point where there are still those who are always accepting of new players into their lives. But the majority of people shut themselves off into private discords and little friendship circles. It makes it a little more complicated to make friends, but it doesn't make it impossible. I definitely wouldn't say the community is hostile though. I always see people getting greeted on the shoutbox and others conversing with each other, which is good to see. I believe that the current staff team is not as connected as the one I was with when I first got promoted to moderator, but that's not really anyone's fault. Sometimes you're going to be forced to work with people you may not like, but you put aside those feelings and do what is best for the community. I definitely didn't like some of the staff members I worked with, but I never straight up told them I disliked them or had an issue with them. It would have just caused more unnecessary tension amongst the staff team. As for the future, I don't know what that holds. I don't plan on going on the LifePunch servers anymore, but I will hop onto the forums whenever I can. As for now, I have no real reason to leave LifePunch. I am, however, happy about one thing leaving LifePunch now, and that is that I have no regrets. I did my shit right over the course of my time. Author's notes. I'd like to thank Degree personally for providing such a detailed public account about his time here in LifePunch, and I'm sure from all the community he will dearly be missed as he has done a great deal for us over time, for which we will always be grateful. Thank you again, Degree. Night Sky. Current super admin. I joined LifePunch in late 2012, so I am quite an experienced member of the community and have learnt a lot of things throughout my time here. My initial impression of LifePunch was the reason why I decided to stay with it for such a long time. It was custom, new, and exclusive. It has the best and most unique UI or HUD, and that grabbed my attention the most. The amount of fun it was is what truly brought my soul into LifePunch though. I'm actually not too sure if LifePunch has gotten better or worse at all. I believe it's more of where our perception lies and what we allow it to be instead. The community determines what LifePunch truly is. Honestly, we're all part of the community, and it is there whether we like it or not. All members can do is change what the sense of community is. I always dreamed of being an admin when I first joined LifePunch. I literally had the most awesome dreams. I had a very immature outlook on being a staff then, but I never imagined to get staff at all, so upper staff was even more far-fetched. I didn't realise my potential until a few months after being an admin. That's when I began to forge my super admin career. I am honestly still shocked that I was selected to be a moderator at all. I applied just for the sake of it, and qualified somehow. In terms of drama, I've never given attention to it. I was indifferent towards it every time. Teenagers will be teenagers. I refuse to be a part of any statistic that contributes towards it. Likewise, in terms of staff drama, they will always do stupid shit just like everyone else. And I don't view staff any different to any other member of the community. I haven't seen a difference in staff over time, but when the word former staff crops up, that makes me think of all the staff before who had the dumbest stuff to get banned or demoted and made a negative everlasting impact on the community. I do, however, miss the old upper staff. The game, Nidruin, pre-cooked. I think they as a team did what I do now a hell of a lot more efficiently. However, for obvious reasons, I would not comment on who I would select as a possible future admin. I do foresee myself being on LifePunch until the very end. However, it is difficult to predict how long it will last, because there is no telling for what could happen. It always keeps going as a standalone Garry's Mod community, as it always was. It might just die out sooner than later. Everything is finite when it comes to duration. I believe LifePunch could expand beyond Garry's Mod to catch a wider audience. It's possible. Monkeys is a game designer, coder, entrepreneur, administrator that the community needs. We have the tools, we just need to make it happen. Of all my time in LifePunch, I do have some regrets. I regret decisions for both myself and others. I definitely regret making a bad impression with Drew. He was a very likeable figure and an important one within LifePunch, and I fucked up my first impression with him. You can never change the first impression, and I never got to appeal to him in a better light. And to this day, it still sucks. Author's notes. Once again, I'd like to extend my thanks to Night Sky for providing a detailed account about his time and experiences here in LifePunch. It is an inspiring story which many people will be able to relate to, and, in some way, humanize the beast that is Night Sky.
Monkeys, the owner. As I am, of course, the founder, I started LifePunch in January of 2011. I like to keep things brief and simple, so here it goes. In terms of drama within the community, it's Garry's Mod and therefore full of 14-year-olds, so it's going to be everywhere. I don't really care or mind, and I don't even try to tackle it. I let it happen because there's no point in trying to stop it. Kids like drama. LifePunch has had to decrease in size of recent times because there are now other Jailbreak servers, along with the fact that players get bored, etc. Jailbreak was a brand new game mode on Garry's Mod back when we released it, and the hype was huge. We were the only server offering it. I never actually ever predicted LifePunch would grow to the size it did. It exploded with demand. In looking towards the future, as long as people play and donate enough through buying LP Dollar, VIP, EVIP to pay the server bills, then LifePunch will go on. I have no intention to ever end it under my own will. In response to the Drew interview below, I refuse to shit talk back to Drew and cause an unnecessary argument. I am too old for this kind of thing. However, there is a part of me that misses Drew somewhat, the sense of nostalgia kicking in. We were good friends at one time, so it's understandable to feel that. Author's notes. I'd just like to send a quick thanks out to Monkeys for answering a few questions for me to help provide a bit of background information and a small amount of his opinions. It certainly helped. Drew P. Richard, former longtime developer. I first joined LifePunch in March of 2011. However, LP didn't have any Garry's Mod servers running until around April that year. It was at that point when I became a developer. I was there from the beginning of the good servers, which is a lot of commitment. But it's how I am. What's the point of doing something if you're not gonna do it to the best of your ability? It's always something I have believed in. I believe that it was always inevitable that I was going to leave considering I was making the lowest amount of money possible and could have made more working at McDonald's. But at the same time, we're working harder than anyone. I haven't regretted anything in my life. If I didn't leave LifePunch, I wouldn't have found my new job, which is similar to that of LifePunch, only I have an office. The people are great, and I earn $22 an hour compared to $9 an hour, so I'm really glad I left. I wish I had done it earlier. I did have my own server at one point, but I didn't like the stress, so I shut it down and got a real job. It's comforting to have a guaranteed paycheck. My side of the story for the reason I left stated on the morning of New Year's Eve. I was laying in bed and just waking up and had nothing to do that day, so I was reading the shoutbox, my normal daily routine. At this time, someone was harassing Lavender, a brand new troll account, and there were three members of staff in the shoutbox talking to me, and none of them were doing anything about the issue. So I asked something along the lines of, hey, why isn't this guy banned yet? And Chance, an admin at the time, decided he wanted to personally attack me and not do anything at all. So we got into an argument in front of everyone, and another admin eventually took care of the troll. However, Monkeys tried to blame me and make me look like the bad guy for arguing with a staff member, and that's why I left. It was the end of the straw. Although I knew LifePunch was not the same, it hadn't felt like home even months before I left. Stupid things like when Monkeys banned memes on the shoutbox and told everyone it was for serious discussion only. To be honest with you all, I don't know why anyone would want to be staff anyway. It's similar to that of babysitting, and I never understood what the appeal of it was anyway. Staff quality has only gotten worse because Monkeys stopped caring and started to pick anyone for staff. If they could fake it, they could make it. Monkeys simply doesn't care anymore about LifePunch. I always cared while I was there. I was passionate about it, and I was truly believe that's why LifePunch has survived for so long anyway. Monkeys' excuses are pointless. If he cared, he would make the time to do so much more for the community. I laugh whenever I hear someone say they're busy. He's so busy that he still finds time to do everything he wants, yet ignores everyone else. LifePunch didn't have the dictatorship feeling it does now. It used to feel like a family, and no one really broke the rules because everyone was cool with each other. I'm not sure when exactly it started to go downhill, but it did, and now it's some dystopian shit. People do what Monkey says or they'll lose staff. I guarantee you he is blackmailing players. It wouldn't be the first time he threatened to call their parents or stir up shit in their personal lives if they were trolls. In terms of Night Sky, I had assumptions before I fully knew him, and it's only been confirmed by everyone he's ever dealt with. He doesn't care about other people. Spooky is the same way. That's why they're both two peas in a pod. I had that feeling about both of them. Then when Night Sky tried to get me in trouble with Monkeys of retarded bullshit not related to LifePunch, he pretty much killed any chance of me ever liking him. I don't really play games anymore, well, not Garry's Mod at least, but I always did like the people. I will tell you that I plan on rewriting every game mode I've ever written out of boredom, and because I can do it better now too. Now that I've left LifePunch, it's just gone to shit. I don't have any affection for it in its current state. I don't miss anything that much, but I had great times growing up with LifePunch, and it taught me things that can never be replaced. And I didn't go to college because of the stuff I learned from developing for LifePunch. LifePunch is still a legacy server on Garry's Mod, but for the people in LifePunch currently, I can't tell anyone what they should do, but I wouldn't have hope anymore. I mean, there wasn't that much drama back in the day. Now there is private circles, and it's gone downhill. If there was only one piece of advice I could give to you readers, it would be to always stick to your values, no matter what. author's notes. Once again, I'd like to send my personal thanks out to Drew for this interview and all of the opinions he has shared. I am sure the readers found it thoroughly interesting seeing things from your point of view. Many people doubted I would ever get an interview with him relating to anything about LifePunch, but he has been totally open and honest about how he feels. A great quality and asset to have. Again, thanks. KoalaKandy, author/EVIP. I think it's only fair that as the author of this short book, I also should share my opinions publicly. I initially joined LifePunch back in 2014 on my old account currently known as Aerostorm. I never really knew much about LP. My friend introduced me to LP and Gary's mod, and it was my first server, and I have stuck with it ever since. Believe it or not, I actually didn't know LP had any other game modes for quite a long time, and I didn't become active on the forums until 2015, whereby I passed my boat kick. I left in summer 2015 and returned on this new account, which was initially called Wafflecopter, changed to KoalaKandy a few months later. I've had way more AFK offenses than you would ever believe on both of my accounts, including this KoalaKandy account. I believe I must hold the most for any regular member ever. It's pretty crazy, and I'm working on fixing that right now, so I just had to get that open and honest out of the way. Otherwise, than that background around me, I'm a pretty friendly player and LifePunch has been a pretty good server to me over the years. I've had plenty of arguments with staff members, especially of recent due to how I believe the current staff team are fragmented. I used to get involved in drama myself, much more than I would have liked, and that's tried to be reduced lately too, in my always improving ideology. I think it's inevitable that drama will be present, and I share similar opinions as many other contributors on this issue. I hope I will be around on LifePunch for much longer because it's a home to me. It's where I check first when I come back from somewhere. It's where you can have a conversation or seek advice from peers when you need it. To me, it's more than a community. It's a place where you still want to be despite all the issues we may face. And I think it's up to us to make LifePunch what we want it to be and move forward to create a better community for each other. Credits. Without all these wonderful people, this book would have never been possible to create. It's your contributions that have helped form a collection discussion for LifePunch, past, present, and future. Thank you again. Ranks are what these people are best known as from their past slash present. The book team, interview contributors, Dr. Turtlenips, VIP, Marcus, EVIP, Metacrisis, regular, Miss Shadow, EVIP, Frozen Galaxy, moderator, Red Baron, VIP, Gnarly, VIP, Snoop, EVIP, Stevie, EVIP, Night Sky, Super Admin, Null Username, VIP, Poppy, VIP, Homeless Haitian, VIP, I'm Ned Arnold, EVIP, Degree, Admin, Monkeys, Owner, Drew P. Richard, Developer, Boobins, VIP, Fisher, EVIP, Crazy Banana, EVIP. Book team and other roles. Instant, VIP, Front Cover Artist, Crazy Banana, Formatter, EVIP, Audiobook Team, Stevie, Video Editor, Fisher, Voice Actor, EVIP, Libenatura, Voice Actor, Regular. Now the words on the back of the cover. The Story of LifePunch. The Story of LifePunch is a book which has allowed members of the community to share their honest opinion about LifePunch without any fear of consequence. Furthermore, this book entails key facts about LifePunch and its history along with exclusive interviews from high-ranking members of staff, such as Monkeys, Owner, Night Sky, Super Admin, Degree, Former Admin, and Drippy Richard, former longtime developer. It's a perfect read for anyone that wishes to understand more about what LifePunch has been through and how their peers feel about it in the past, present, and estimations for the future.